going to move on to Apple, specifically the iPhone 4, which will be carrying Verizon Wireless. Apple is really the phone that, or the manufacturer, the company that changed everything. It's what really puts smartphones into people's hands that would normally have not gotten smartphones. It made things very simplistic. It incorporated software using application-based views and just really completely changed the market. It's what Android is pretty much based on, applications, simplicity. So Apple, you're not going to think of as Microsoft, where you can get different platforms, different form factors. Apple is very much like BlackBerry. So Apple not only makes the phone, but they also make the software. It's called iOS. Very simplistic, very user-friendly, great experience. It's an application workhorse. So it has the most applications of any manufacturer's smartphone out there. One of the differentiations between Apple and Google, however, is 65% of the applications that Google has, and we're talking about hundreds of thousands of applications, are free. Whereas 35% of Apple's, upwards of 300,000 to 400,000 are free as well. So you do have more applications with Apple, but not all of them are free, or not most of them are not free like Google, and that's because Google gets most of their money from advertising and different, whereas Apple, is really a manufacturing company, so they're getting their income from not only the handset, but also computers and applications as well. It also has the hotspot with Verizon Wireless, has Skype Mobile. The iPhone 4, the really big differentiator is it's a beautiful phone, right? It's very, very stylistic. It's one of those phones where image is important. It has a Retina display, which is the brightest display of any manufacturer. It's got a nice stainless steel feel, so it's very sturdy. It's got a glass finish. 3.5-inch screen, so it's not a terribly large screen, but that display really makes things pop out at you because it's such a vibrant display. You're not going to get a lot of customization with the Apple. You can set up folders so if you have real estate applications and you have media applications, you can put those in folders so that you can find them very, very easily. But you're not going to get a lot of differentiation that, like you would with Google. Extremely solid product, proven product. But you just have to keep in mind that the iPhone is the iPhone. You don't get anything else in terms of form factor, in terms of a new iPhone coming out. It's completely determined by when Apple wants to release it. Whereas Android or BlackBerry, not even BlackBerry, but Android, Motorola wants to come out with a new phone, they'll do it. Samsung wants to come out with a new phone, they'll do it. So just keep that in mind with the iPhone, but extremely proven product, very application-based, very streamlined, smooth product. Does have the front-facing video with Skype. FaceTime is really what its strength is, and FaceTime does not work on 3G. You have to be in Wi-Fi capable, but FaceTime is a free video conferencing where you can do it with any Apple product, so any MacBook Air or MacBook Pro, any iPod that has the front-facing camera or another iPhone. That's the FaceTime video conferencing that they're really strong with, and very smooth as well.
But you have to be where there's Wi-Fi.
You have to be where there's Wi-Fi, correct. Correct. That's one limitation to the FaceTime.
But it comes in nice.
Yeah, it's very, very, and when Apple does things, they do them very crisp. They take their time with it. They're not a very open platform, which is one of the complaints, but by not being a very open platform, they're very solid platform, right? They're very proven. They've sold millions and millions of these devices, and outside of maybe network connectivity, the actual device has been really embraced by consumers. And we're very happy with Verizon Wireless to finally have Apple on our team as well to give our customers that option that wants an Apple product or has very integration. So if someone wants a BlackBerry, Android, and Apple, now we have Verizon Wireless to give that opportunity to everybody. Any specific questions with Apple?
So if Apple had the G4 or whatever, that would blow them out of the water.
not necessarily blow them out of the water.
I mean, if in fact that was the case, like right now, the advantage for Android is the G4.
The 4G?
4G, yeah. 4G.
Not necessarily. The advantage of Android is the open platform customization. It's also the form factor capability. So if somebody really wants a keyboard, they have that option with Android. The integration with Google is really the main thing. The advantage of Apple is you have a lot of applications that people are very familiar with. Much better battery life. Apple's going to give you much better battery life than Android.
What would you say the majority of realtors have? Would they be more beneficial with Android or with an Apple?
Honestly,
I know you guys are promoting more Android product, I would say, but
yeah.
If there's statistics that show that, but because I've heard some realtors say, "Hey, you know, get the iPhone because this particular application is more beneficial to your business versus."
Right. What I've seen in the studies that we've shown, and you'll see in terms of the applications, real estate specific applications are duplicated with Google and Android. So Realtor.com is a very popular one. Smarter Agent is a very popular one. Any mortgage calculator is a very popular one. So when you're talking about Android versus Apple, really you're talking about applications, you're talking about developers. So developers, you just have to keep in mind that Android's much newer in terms of applications. So developers are getting more involved with Android and duplicating the same applications that you, so you don't have Apple specific applications that won't be available for Android. That's just not the case. It's just a matter of, is this application available for both Google and Android? And in a real estate perspective, the answer is usually yes. It's really hard to differentiate one of the other because they both have their strengths. If battery life is really, really important. Having a thin phone and an image is really important. The one we go with iPhone. If having the capability of having a larger screen, having a Gmail integration, having access to more free applications, having a real keyboard, then you would go with Android. So it's really difficult for me to kind of answer that question just because in my experience, people lean more towards Apple because it's the Kleenex factor, right? So if you want a tissue, usually people say you want a Kleenex because that's what you know. You want to make a copy of something, you Xerox it, but obviously. So when you want a smartphone that can do capabilities, you know, in the last 2 years I went an iPhone because that's what started the whole game. But as Android and even Palm and HP get involved, there's going to be really a lot of differentiation between the two, but giving you the same solutions. And that's kind of why I'm here, to kind of educate you that Apple, although is extremely proven product, they're not the only game in town. And we've seen that it's the Kleenex and Xerox factor.
Do you see Android surpassing Apple because they got so many people doing apps and more people designing and so forth? And Apple has their, you know, methodical way.
I can only speak to articles that I've read and a numbers game. So Android is currently invested in all four cell phone companies, T-Mobile, Sprint, AT&T, and Verizon. Not only are they integrated in all four, so everybody can have access to an Android phone, but they have access to, you know, each company probably carries 10 to 12 different Android phones. So if I walk in and I want a small entry-level Android phone, I can do that. If I want a high-end 4.3-inch screen with an HDMI output Android phone, I can do that. If I want a 4G Android phone, I can do that. If I want an iPhone, I have to go to only Verizon or AT&T, and I have to specifically pick the iPhone of that year that's in stock. So based on numbers, they're just covering more people. So If things stay the same, it's projected, based on studies I've read, by 2015 that Android would be the leading operating system worldwide. just because they'd be across the board more than Apple. So, but everything can change. I mean, Apple can offer more iPhone or Apple products across, you know, all the different carriers as well, and that would completely change things. But as it stands, just like BlackBerry, you can go to any manufacturer, or I'm sorry, any wireless carrier, you get a BlackBerry. You know,